Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for coming back. I always get asked this question, what does a stool test tell you about your health? And that's what we're going to talk about in this video. And how is everyone out there? Thanks for tuning into my channel. I always appreciate it. Have you guys subscribed yet? It'd be cool if you could. We're going to get lots more videos up on this channel. Subscribers get the priority. They're the ones who usually get answered the key questions. So here's a key question. What does a stool test tell you about your health? A stool test tells you an enormous amount about your health. It's incredible. A long, long time ago when I started to practice, stool testing was available, but not many people were using it. And wind the clock forward 30 plus years, not many people are still using that stool test. I know this from talking to lots and lots of people all around the world. I work with about people now in over 70 countries. It's incredible. Now, most people have never even heard of a stool test. All right? The kind of test I'm going to show you guys in a minute. And if they have had a test done, it's been completed generally by a medical practitioner or through a clinic, and it'll only be for a very little narrow parasite screen. That's all it'll be for. Imagine if you guys are going for a driving test, okay? And the instructor takes you out and he says, can you see that sign over there? And you say, yeah, it says stop. Okay, you're passed. You got your license, right? Or fail. It says stop. It doesn't say go to McDonald's. Well, that's a bit like what a doctor does with a conventional pathology stool test. They just do one tiny little thing, and that's it, all right? The comprehensive stool analysis is like going for the full shebang, going for the full driving test, all right? Everything's exposed. All of your weaknesses are exposed. All of your strengths are exposed. Everything is checked out carefully, all right? But in this case, you're not going to fail. There's no pass or fail on the stool test, all right? So let's talk about the stool test. What is it? Well, it's comprehensive. That's what it is. It's called comprehensive stool analysis or comprehensive digestive stool analysis. There are many companies that offer this test, but in my opinion, there are only two labs that you want to take seriously. The rest are okay, but these are the two main players that I work with. Stool testing reveals a fantastic amount about your health, but there are a couple of protocols that need to be really understood if you want to get the best out of a stool test. Many practitioners don't understand this information I'm about to tell you because they don't do this test as often as I do or don't have experience in using it a lot. In our clinic, we've performed over 5,000 stool tests. I can easily say that by the sheer amount of people that we've seen that we've stool tested. It'll be beyond 5,000. If I go to my filing cabinets, bulging at the seams, there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of these reports. I'm not a smart person, but I am a person who's quite observant. I look a lot at things, and I observe things, and I study things. I might not have a PhD, but I've helped a lot of people out getting better or improving their health through this stool test. Once you get a grip of this test and use it a lot, and use it frequently, you get to understand how it fits with the patient. And particularly, you'll understand the markers that you see how they reflect in either good health or poor health with the client. And particularly with the test I'm going to show you here, this is a particularly bad test or not so good one. But this guy at the moment is feeling in fantastic condition in spite of all the years he's been sick. So let's give you an overview of the stool test first. If you look at any conventional stool test, there are multiple pages to it. So there are lots of different markers that we look at. It takes me usually 5 minutes to analyze a stool test, because I've looked at so many. I generally know what markers to look for and how to put which markers together to try and work out what's going on with the patient. So the front page of most tests that I look at tends to be the bacteriology panel or the yeast culture. So bacteria carefully assessed in the gut. We're looking at the bad ones, the dysbiotic ones, which can be good ones that have grown out of proportion. We're looking at imbalanced bacteria, so bacteria going in transition from good to bad. And we're looking at beneficial bacteria, at the expected beneficial count. These can be bacteria like lactobacillus, you may have heard of this name, bifidobacteria. We've got Escherichia coli or E. coli. These are bacteria that are okay for the body. But again, you don't really want any bacteria in massive amounts overgrowing others. It's all about the balance, about the harmony. And when we look at the panels, we can generally start seeing right away where the balances or imbalances are. So where's my pen? Hang on a minute. I'll just grab my pen, you guys. Looks like someone's flogged my pen. All right, so here you can see we've got this panel here, which is good because nothing should be in there. We've got the imbalanced panel here, and we've got the beneficials over here. So we want to get a high count here, of course, with the good, and we want no count with the bad. So the front page tells me a lot about the bacteria and the yeasts. Right? The second page, with further information, gives me information on parasites in the body. Good labs, each of the three samples, if it's a time 3 test, will be tested independently. The not so good labs mix all the samples together. The benefit of the stool test is having so much information in such a small document that could really help to guide you, the patient, into getting better and also making you understand why you're not recovering. The amount of stuff I've picked up in these stool tests over the years has been absolutely, absolutely phenomenal. The misdiagnosis, the stuff-ups from specialists, the complete stuff-ups from other practitioners giving patients completely wrong advice because they weren't tested. People who were treated for conditions they never needed to be treated for because assumptions were made, tests weren't performed, and dumb things would, happen because of that. All right? So stool tests are going to give you these kind of markers. You should be looking for these markers. So I mentioned the bacteria culture, a yeast panel, a parasite panel, an inflammation, section. There should be inflammatory markers to show, if you've got inflammatory conditions or irritated conditions like irritable bowel syndrome, food allergies, etc. You should also notice there things like digestion parameters. So often a pancreatic marker called elastase will show on the test. And again, on at least 100 or more occasions, I found a very low pancreatic elastase marker where the practitioner who performed the test said everything was perfectly fine, but I picked up it was not fine. And once we corrected that, the patient improved incredibly. More recently, we've got a patient from the west side of America who spent over $100,000 on tests and products that got a total resolution of symptoms within 8 weeks on a stool test. Basic supplements were used. We just used Candida for cleaning up the gut. We made a diet change after the stool test, and the results were awesome with this patient. Yet $100,000 was spent, with literally dozens of tests the patient never needed to do. If you've got a gut problem, get a stool test done. If you've been sick a long, long time, and particularly if you've had antibiotics, let me say that again, antibiotics, if you've had those, you need stool testing. I had a patient yesterday, a woman who's 56 with interstitial cystitis, okay, so basically inflamed bladder. Now, this poor lady, 10 years ago, had 6 months of antibiotics by her dentist for a supposed, tooth that was a little bit suspect. So he put this lady on antibiotics for 6 months. It's ruined her gut. Now her gut has calmed down, but the bladder and the waterworks are playing up now. So that's going to be a stool test. Even though she's not really symptomatic with the gut, we want to correct the gut to get a good result with the bladder. Right? That's the advantage of the stool test. I can't tell you how many cases I've resolved with comprehensive stool analysis. Now these tests aren't cheap. These tests may cost around $400 or $500, New Zealand dollars. It could be $300 or $400 US dollars. But is $300 or $400 worth it? Of course it's worth it for your health. Of course it's worth it if you're feeling like crap. But you need to see someone who understands stool testing. And there are plenty of good practitioners out there that understand stool testing in the US, in Europe, in many countries. And if you can't find one, it's a matter of going to an association, a naturopathic association, or an integrative medical association, or even go to the labs themselves, or email them, or find out a doctor who does integrative medicine or functional diagnostic medicine. That's a much better approach for you if you've been sick a long time and you're sick of these standard pathology tests that get you nowhere, all right? You may not have parasites, you may not have candida, you may have something entirely different. A test will clear the way. It'll take away all that confusion. You'll understand what's going on. You'll understand it. You should have some sort of timeline then also regarding recovery, right? And you don't need to spend a ton of money on supplements or tests. A few basic tests are what most people need. Excuse me, not rafts and rafts of tests like that poor man in America spent all that money. So think about it. That's the comprehensive stool test. And what was the question again? What does a stool test tell you about your health? It tells you everything about your health, because your gut is the seat of your health. And if you can understand what's wrong with the seat and fix the seat up, you can improve your health 100-fold. Thanks for tuning in.